What they are is a stainless steel canopy, and a cooker is going to be sitting under there. And the stainless steel canopy is going to hang off that iron. Surprised didn't have to be stainless, but this is just the support structure, so I guess it didn't matter. Engineer called for that, so I don't think I've ever had you guys down here much. All right, boys, this is our geek a hole punch. I forget the diameter, but you get the idea. But it's got an angle slot right there, see? Shear attachment for square stock and round stock. 18-inch plate by inch. Then on this end down here, you got a notcher. Yeah, I can show you guys how it works, I guess. Take some angle. That thing here, you gotta tighten up before you shear. Foot pedal operated. Pretty fast and simple, huh? Take it around there, pop a hole in it. Come over here. Wanna trim an edge off something? You're gonna do structural steel, you gotta have something like this though. Yeah, there was a time we did 100 ton of steel or more out of a month out of here. Amazing when you think about it, but that's not that much really. One beam can weigh 2,000 pounds, so guy fab get about 10 of them out the door a day, and tons add up quick. So this is how they cut things down here, very uncivilized, I call it. Damn, sparks flying everywhere. Look at that. This was made by Road King. Oh. Pretty mean saw though. It's real fast on handrail. It's faster. This was basically for handrails, what it's for. That's why it's just got this little channel on it. If Gravity One's watching this video, there's a couple straight notchers for handrail. That's what you use a lot. You don't use a lot of compound angles the way you make handrail, unless it's stairs, you know, but the majority of the handrail ain't stairs, it's just flat. But got these big tables. You guys thought my shop was big, huh? Nice crane truck. Another big fab table back here. Basically all you need in a structural steel shop is that punch I showed you. Torches, you know, not a whole lot of tools. Basically welders, you know, and shit to cut with. But you just need space, basically. Unload trucks and everything. Rack of steel, put, make your clip angles out of. Plate and stuff. Boys, we're short piece in the middle there. Gonna have to run over to the steel house, pick it up. All right, boys, we gotta fire up the old International here. Wait till that light goes off. There we go. No CDL. Don't give a shit. Make way, coming through. I used to be a hell of a truck driver back in the day before cell phones. Now that they're cell phones, you can kiss my ass. I used to like it when you had to plan your day and you took off in the morning, gone all day, nobody bothering you. Now they call every 5 minutes instead of planning anything. No thanks. Big old stadium though for that Super Bowl, and Peyton Manning gets fucked up. Everybody kissing his ass still. Like I say, he can piss off. He should have stayed here his whole career. Everybody's like, oh, just want to support him. Oh yeah, the poor guy. Bet he's having trouble eating, poor guy. You want to get some iron, the best place to go is a big place like this. Buy it in 20-foot lengths. When you go to these places, don't pull in and block the goddamn door. You're going to piss the guy off. If you're in a little truck or trailer or whatever, just park out of the way and go inside to the will call desk. And then have them tell you where to go so you ain't got the guy mad at you. And then the guy in there with that hook, that's the most important guy in the place. Piss him off, he'll go hide in the back forever. Pretty big shop, huh? Let's look at all that damn iron. Imagine the frames and trailers and shit you could make out of that stuff.
What you doing, Tracer?
Trace does not like being in the fence. But he's a pain in the butt.
you gotta stay in there, Pop-Pop. Don't try to find your way out. Look at him. He's going to the gate trying to get his way out. You gonna open that gate? I gotta put a lock on it or he opens it. You gotta stay here, Pop-Pop. I got work. You gotta stay. I got work to do. I got work to do, man. You stand there and guard Grandma. You gotta guard Grandma. It's your job, buddy. I'll be back. All right, boys, here we are downtown Indianapolis, about 5:30 in the morning. They go in this door. See these frames because it's too dark, but they take those frames we made in this little door. Look at this rat's nest. We got 8 guys trying to take a door off. All right, boys, we got her in place. All right, guys, there they are in place. We're done. Get the flock out of here. Didn't scratch the floor. Didn't drop it on nothing. Good to go.
I'm back, Papa. You ready? You ready?
All right, boys. Got that little job done. Couldn't film much because of the damn mayor and shit, but got one more little thing we can do to make a little money today. Let's go get it.
All right, boys. There's a little project to work on. See, it got a little mangled up there somehow.
Gotta have some good shop help, huh? Lou's gonna operate.
Let's see if we can get her straightened out a little. Hell, I might even be able to do it without any heat.
North Branch could never do it without heat, but up in our expect South Branch could. It's gonna take a little heat. Just had a paying customer leave on another little job. He said, there ain't guys like you ain't around very much anymore. I said, ain't that the truth? I guess he meant the welding, but.
Getting closer. All right, boys, you bored yet? I told you, that's why I don't make daily videos. But clean this up so I can weld it. Come back to hit it here and here. Then I know it's gonna keep that nice and stiff. Go on, Lou, get burnt up.
Just to keep the customers happy.
All right, boys, with Lou and Trace's help, I got this done. Turned out pretty good. Haul that back down to the neighbors to get paid. Before I go here, I want to give a shout out, thank you to W1 Weasel. Go check out him. He sent me this shop manual for this Honda. I think I'm turning Japanese. I really think so. Oh, I know it's not a classic piece of American iron, but it was my grandpa's. So I want to try to get it going. It's pretty neat, really. It's got a radiator, fan, rubber engine mounts, little 13 horse twin cylinder. But it's running good, but the problem with it is hydrostatic's pulsing. It like jerks, it's jerky. And check the fluid, it's got fluid from that manual. I think it might have air in the line, but a couple of mechanics have looked at this and couldn't get it running. And my stepdad kind of assumed that I couldn't just because his mechanic buddies couldn't, so now it's a dare and I have to get it running. So I know it's not a piece of a classic American iron, but it was my grandpa's and I want to keep it running. It's really a nice tractor though. So oh well, until then, I don't know, drink a cold 500. Y'all wanted daily videos. It's probably too, so boring you don't want another one, but oh well, come on guys, let's go fire up the grill, get paid. Peace. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all.